had asthma pretty much since I was a little kid. And I wasn't able to do a lot of things that a lot of people could do, like gym class and things like that.
When I was a kid, I really wanted to be an astronaut. And I found out that if you couldn't breathe properly, you probably couldn't be an astronaut. So there's one crushed dream.
I don't want to go in the hospital. I just want to play basketball, hang out with my friends, go to school.
You know, I mean, I don't have asthma, so I don't know what he goes through. But, you know, they've gave us, you know, good analogies.
Just imagine putting a plastic bag over your head and trying to breathe for 10 seconds. And, you know, just, I couldn't imagine that.
I live by the ocean, want to surf. It always would get in my head, well, what if this happened when I was out on the water?
It's there every day. It's like a light bulb that's glowing all the time. It's just a question of how bright the light is at any given point. And so we try to work with our families to help them reconceptualize the disease from an episodic disease that comes and goes to a chronic disease that the child lives with every single day.
I don't go to the hospital as frequently as I used to.
So our clinical research is really a partnership between the researchers and the patients. We can't do our research without them.
And it's just a wonderful thing, having the security and that great feeling that you have a support system.
Now I can exercise without panicking and I can sleep better.
It has changed my life a great deal coming through this study. I learned so much. Sometimes now when I'm short of breath, I don't feel like I have to go hide. I don't have to say, I left something in my office and then not come back for 30 minutes.
We treat patients with asthma. And at the same time, we're investigating how microbes in their airways, in their body, and in their environment may interact with their asthma.
To have Dr. G actually spend time with me without looking at the clock has been just unbelievable. That's the way medicine's supposed to be.
There's no one-size-fits-all medication for the treatment of asthma. A lot of advances have been made by trying to identify specific pathways that are active in individual patients.
And basically, they do all these different tests that, you know, evaluate every aspect of her asthma. Just I wish a lot of people would hear about these studies and be a part of them, because they can definitely help a lot of individuals.
What we typically do is take the samples we get from the patients. We're able to bring them to our research labs where we use them in translational research experiments. And those are the samples that allow us to make progress and potential advances in asthma therapeutics.
So when you treat asthma patients, you want to make sure that you treat their biology, and that's what medications do. But you also need to make sure that their environment is improved so that you get rid of the triggers that may exacerbate their asthma.
It's that individualized, personalized approach that's really going to define asthma care in the future.